everyone, and welcome to the first episode of Salesforce Labs Live. My name is Marianna Torres, and I lead all promotions for Salesforce Labs. I am so excited to be joining you here today as we dive in and learn more about these free employee-built solutions. This series is designed to introduce you to some of the newest Salesforce Labs apps to hit the AppExchange marketplace and guide you through the capabilities of these spectacular solutions. Today, we'll hear all about the new upcoming Salesforce Labs app, OrgCheck, and how you can use it to visualize your org's dependencies, reduce technical debt, and obtain insight into APIS classes in need of optimization. But before we dive in, I just want to remind everyone to please make all buying decisions off products that are currently available. Salesforce Labs brings free employee-built solutions to AppExchange, the world's leading cloud-based enterprise. Remember, while Salesforce Labs solutions are free to use, some of them require paid features to work. As you know, trust is our number one value here at Salesforce, and so all Salesforce Labs solutions are required to go through the exact same security review process as our partners. Many of our solutions are also open source, so you can use them and customize them to meet your business's unique needs. Finally, it is my great pleasure to introduce to you our special guest for today. Joining us here today is Vincent Finet, a senior program architect here at Salesforce and one of our newest builders under the Salesforce Labs program. Vincent, why don't you take a moment to introduce yourself and your new app?
Sure, Marianna. Thank you very much for the introduction. So, hello, everyone. My name is Vincent. I'm a Salesforce employee located in France, helping customers to achieve their vision with our lovely products from Salesforce. I'm going to show you the app that I built on the Salesforce platform to reduce some of your org's technical debt. The application came from a vision I had about a tool that would help me and others automate all the data manipulation that I was doing and performing during org assessment, which is the process where you want to highlight all the technical debt of your customer's org. So in the next slide, we will see that the technical debt is somehow an invisible thing and a negative thing. In short, you need to have a discussion with your customer and your team about that, and so that everyone agrees that we need to reduce that technical debt, not once in a while, not once every 10 years, but continuously. And it will lead to a better performance, easier and cheaper maintenance, and so many great things. So now, are you ready to reduce that technical debt? Of course. Let's go to the next slide and see what tool you can use. The app I had in mind is somehow a collection of use cases that I had that you may have during the discovery of your org, like you need some documentation on your objects, you need to cleanse your metadata, you need so many great things that are in the slide that I'm not going to go one by one. And the spirit of the application was that it needed to be simple to install, like an AppExchange application. What's so easy to install than an AppExchange application? Nothing? Okay, you got it. It needs to be secure also, because in this application, it will not expose any data and any metadata outside of your Salesforce org. Everything will be on your desktop, on your browser, and within your org, the org that you want to analyze. It needs to be visual. It needs to highlight the thing that you need to focus on, and it will in the background extract, transform whatever data to do the job. And then you will focus on reduce that technical debt. So let's go to the next slide and introduce OrgCheck. So you see that little icon that I did, mascot. You can choose whatever you want. It's a rat. It's a ratatouille. it's a dog, whatever you want, but the tool is called OrgCheck. And it came from, that was a kind of a journey from a personal tool to an open source project. And now let's go through some use cases just to present you the heart of the application. So let's go through in the next slide, 7 use cases that I had in mind. And we will go through those 7 use cases during the demo. Let's switch to the demo. Now I need to share my screen. There you go. And the magic will happen if I can go here. Okay. So let's assume that you install OrgCheck in your application, in your org. You have this application, OrgCheck, and you have a lot of tabs and crazy emoticons here. Anyway, that's not the magic of the application, but it's funny. Use case number one, you need some information about your objects. So you will click on the object tab and then it will load some stuff. Everything that the application is loading is located on the browser. Okay, so no crazy objects, extra object in this application. And you will select, for example, let's say the account object, which is rather standard. And you will see in one page everything you need about this object, the X figure. The limits. Oh, I'm okay on this one. I will see all the fields, and for the custom fields, I will be able to check the dependencies of that fields, of those fields, and then whoa, wait a minute. I see some custom fields that are not used anymore. So I need to focus on them. Okay. So let's switch to the second use case. The second use case is I need to clean my custom fields. Okay, second tab. As everybody, I have custom fields all over the place. What I need to know very fast is among those custom fields, which custom field is not used? Okay, so here, what I'm doing is I'm listing all the custom fields in the org, and I'm just computing a score, which is somehow a badness score. And I put 1 if I found no dependency for that particular custom field. And if you need some information about the score, you can click on the question mark and then you will have, okay, oh yeah, okay, now I understand how the score is computed. Let's go here. And then you see, I will need to check those rows. Use case number 3, I need to understand what this field is used for. Okay, so for the fields that are used, let's say I'm looking for a field which is called email. Okay, this is the one. Oh, I need to check that one. And I will see that the dependency API is giving me this. Not very useful information, but that was for the demo. And then let's switch to the use case number 4. I want to visualize the role hierarchy. Oh boy, that's a custom thing. You come to a new org and then you need to get a view of the role hierarchy. Honestly, the standard way to see the role hierarchy is rather, let's say, not sexy, okay? And this one, it's starting to be more gentle than the standard one. So let's see. So I have a couple of roles here, and most of the information that needs my attention is in yellow. So obviously those roles have no users. Okay, I'm here as a user. This is a development org, and in all those roles, nobody. So I need to get attention to this. Next use case, I need to have information about click and point automation in my org. So let's go to the automation tab. you will notice that the dog is also breathing if you take some attention. I'm a crazy freak about details. So let's go back to the demo. So on the automation, you have three subtabs: workflows, process builders, and flows. And every time you have this score, and the highest is the one with the biggest score. And here, honestly, that is a workflow that is not activated with no action in it. Let's get rid of it, okay? What about process builders that we want to migrate to flows? Same thing. We see some crazy things about them, and also flows. It's not active and it has no description. Oh boy. Okay, so now we are on use case number 6, and this developer org already gets me an headache. But let's go through the use case number 6. I need to check the Apex class. Okay, so for this particular tab, you need to make sure that all the classes have been compiled, and you have some things here to compile all the classes. And then if you want some information about the unit tests, you need to run them all through this button. Okay. And once it's done, then you will see that, okay, it's not that, oh yeah, it's bad. Okay. So here, what I see is that you see that the score is bad here, and it's for because of, you see the yellow, a little darker yellow here. So 4 is for very old API here. It has no specified sharing. So it should be with sharing or without sharing. And it has no coverage and no dependency. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's it. So with this, I will be able to make sure that my classes are more relevant. And also, I will be able to see which Apex test is participating into my code coverage. Okay. Last but not the least, I want to see the Apex triggers per object. So let's go here. And then I have a third tab, the object trigger count. I see that all my objects have only one active triggers except one content version. And that's against the law of Salesforce. By best practices, it should be one. So it needs my attention. Okay, so that's the end of demo. Let's switch back to you, Marianna, for the presentation.
Vincent, thank you so much for joining us here today. I'm sure our trailblazers are eager to try out your spectacular new solution, and we can't wait until it goes live. Remember, everyone, OrgCheck is not yet available on AppExchange, so be sure to follow us on Twitter at Salesforce Labs to be notified the moment it's available for installation. In the meantime, you can browse through all current Salesforce Labs solutions through the link on the screen. Our talented community of builders are always bringing new innovation to AppExchange. Visit us at bit.ly/labsapps to explore more ways to extend your Salesforce environment for free. And that concludes today's session. Thank you, everyone, for joining us here today. We hope you enjoyed this episode and look forward to bringing you more exciting content. Is there a specific topic or app you want us to cover? Feel free to let us know by tagging us on Twitter. Drop a comment our way and let us know what you thought of today's episode. Remember, you can explore more video content from the Salesforce Labs team by visiting the official AppExchange YouTube channel. Thanks again, everyone. Catch you next time.